I had a special surprise prepped and everything. But it looks to me like your hands are full. No biggie. We can always tweak the rules a bit. Does not get eaten. Sound like fun? Of course it does.
Run, Sam, run!
Thank you. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. You alright?
Going, Sam.
Sorry, I'll try to make this quick.
Brain stopped.
You there, Sam? The hospital I was staying at was crushed by a bridge. Still have nightmares about it. Still hear the crack before it all came tumbling down. I've been scared to death of bridges ever since. And, yeah. I know how that must sound, considering our employer. I'm scared of the dark, too. Don't sleep anymore. Can't.
Thank you for your... Deploying. Thank you for your contribution.
Got it.
Hey, you okay?
You can do it.
This one's for you. Thanks for the help. All right, let's get this done. Thank you.
and Sam. Cutters. Hey, Sam. Do you remember your own birth? Me, I remember being inside the womb. I wasn't alone. I could hear my mother's heartbeat. Hers. And Lachna. We were conjoined twins. One and the same before we were born. But then they tried to separate us. The surgery. The operation was successful. We were still one. We knew each other's thoughts without saying a word. My joy to her joy. Her pain was my pain. And no distance was too great for us to overcome. Some might call it a kind of telepathy. Divided in body, mind and spirit. We had a beach just for us. One we shared. Our own private chiral network, you might say. With Cupids, we can build one that will let everyone share what Lachna and I have. I saw it all laid out before me after I signed up for Bridges. We could unite everyone. No matter how scattered or different. It can make us whole. We can do it. Well, Sam, it wouldn't be about bringing people into line. It would be about bringing them into the fold, where they would share. Share alike. I knew it could change the world. With Amelie's help, we finalized the Cupid design. But after the attack and the birth, everything changed. For the first time in my life, Lachna wasn't there. But I'm not alone anymore. I can feel her again. Thank you, Sam. I feel whole again. You and me, sis. Me and you.
Beginning scan. Shannon Bridges ID. Verifying ID. clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. All clear. Welcome, Sam Porter Bridges.
Ringing. No. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I love you so much. Good to hear your voice again. I shouldn't have kept you in the dark. Tried to save her. I couldn't. You don't have to say any more. I'll admit, you need to fix his Cupid. I couldn't save our child, but you can save our world. Only you. I love you. You hear me? Forever. And always. Now. Make the world whole, okay? Just like you make me. All that she went through, I had no idea. I thought she'd severed our bond on purpose, that she'd stole our child and ran. I fixed your Cupid like she asked. The limiter should be functioning properly now. There is one thing. Before I sat down to work, I took a long, hard look at the code. I'm pretty sure someone's tweaked it. Either that, or my memory's going to pieces.
Someone rewrote your code?
Rewrote might be overstating it. Let's just say it wasn't the latest version I released. And yet, because of it, I was finally reunited with Malingan. Could be we found our culprit already. She died beneath the rubble, with our child still inside her. Her ka passed over to the other side, but her ha remained, bound to our dead daughter. She knew all of this, of course. That's why she kept one cuff loose. Didn't want anyone seeing her vitals. Shame she couldn't use her favorite invention. She did all that to keep me and our daughter safe. Sis? I can hear you. We're whole again. We're one. Like before in the womb, remember? Lingen. Lachna.
Thanks to you, Edgenot City is finally within reach. And you, Lachna, your work will help ensure that the Chiral Network remains online. Together, we might just make it all the way west. Now then, Sam, there's something else you ought to know. We've been studying the data from when you claim you encountered those soldiers. We had audio, which doesn't paint a complete picture on its own, but the languages, the names, and terms we picked out, the munitions we could identify, everything seems to indicate that you were on a battlefield over 100 years ago. World War I, to be precise. It wasn't a dream. Wasn't a hallucination. Maybe you were spirited away to another dimension or something. And given the time discrepancies, maybe you were sent to a beach. Can't say anything for certain. That said, I've never heard of a beach turned into a battlefield. But beaches are shaped by the will of the people who inhabit them. Perhaps Hartman can offer a more rational explanation. Beaches are his specialty. Unfortunately, he's still outside the Chiral Network. Anyway, get some rest. No use dwelling on questions we can't answer yet.
Your work is greatly appreciated.